Well, this is 5 months after the video where I set this up, and I've been using it for these 5 months, and I'm just telling you, this is one fine machine. It's just runs quiet, excellent dust collection. Once I got it set up, it cuts perfectly straight and flat. But that shop box stand that I got from my buddy Tony that came with this was just a piece of junk. It couldn't roll across this this crack, and so I welded up this this new stand here just out of I had a piece of 4x6 3/8 angle iron that I got. Someone actually gave it to me because I was nice and dropped some stuff off for them from the steel place. They didn't have a trailer, and I had my trailer, and I wasn't expecting anything, but they gave me a 20 footer of this stuff. It was coming out of a job, so I built all kinds of things out of it. But one thing that helped me was when I disassembled that shop box, the way I did it, and I'll show you a picture right now, is I used this open space here to slip boards up underneath it and lift it up, because I didn't want to lift up on the unit, on the table, since I had spent so much time getting them so precisely aligned. I didn't want to mess with them at all. So I wanted to do all the lifting from down here below. And so when I lifted that up and got that thing out, then a light went off on how to build this. And I didn't really film or do much because it's hot and I was grumpy and didn't really think it was that important. But I wish I would have filmed more. But so this is welded to this upside down, cut away here for, you know, the movement of the casters. And so I made basically two identical pieces with this drop in here. And the other good thing about this is that I didn't want to raise this up that high, because, you know, I like tools that are tall, but I don't like a joiner that's too tall, because a joiner you have to kind of get your weight down on top of sometime. So I only increased the overall height of the joiner by 2 inches, which it worked out really great with this design of stand. So what I did is I made the two parts, I got it all painted up, and then this piece of angle iron bolts into a plate that's welded on the inside here. And then I welded some angle iron tabs here, and then it's bolted there. So I can take this out and then the one on the back, and it separates. So that's what I did also, is I lifted the thing up again when I was ready to. So all I had to do was just slip it in from the side and, you know, get it up underneath there, slip the other one in from the side, and then lower it down, and then it was sitting on this. And then I was able to just pop that angle iron piece down in there and get the bolts in place, and, you know, the rest is history. But let me show you, I'll bring the camera over, and let me show you, there's four positions here where I can isolate, I can disengage the rollers. You know, a joiner is not a machine you want to be chasing around your shop, you know, pushing heavy material through it. So I took some 3/4 inch all thread and welded a nut onto the top, and there's a nut welded on the bottom here too. And then for alignment, I cut a 1 inch OD bushing, 3/4 ID bushing, and press fit it into all four of these. So it's actually riding on a bronze bushing here, and then threaded through a nut here on the bottom. And I made some little feet by taking some round drops that I always save at my drill press from doing hole saw work, some 1/4 inch things that were probably about 2 inches in diameter. Welded a little stub of pipe on it, put them on the bottom, drilled a hole through the rod and the top of the pipe, and then just put a piece of wire through it so they won't fall off when you lift it up. But let me bring the camera over, and I'll show you these some close-ups, and here, let me show you right now, you know, how easy it is to just isolate this. I can level this out when I'm ready. So that, you know, that's just the two front ones, but it works really well. Here, let me show you how easy it rolls too. One of the problems with that shop box piece of junk is that it wouldn't roll across this crack in my floor. So this is a solid 500 pounds. you know. So yeah, I can just get this thing. I can snuggle it away in the corner if I'm not using it, if I need space. And that shop box stand was just, it was terrible. But let me bring the camera up and I'll show you these feed here and stuff. I can get down and show you these feed and the bushing and what have you. So of course you can, you know, make it go up and down just by turning this thing. And then this is your jam nut. Once you get it into position and get it leveled, you can just jam it. But you can maybe see the faint outline of where I put that bronze bushing in there or pressed it in. I don't know if you can, because you know I put chemchromic primer, and then I only put one coat of that Sure Chem on there, but there is a bronze bushing in there. I drilled a 1-inch hole there, pressed it in, so it's 1-inch OD, 3/4-inch ID. And then, you know, here's what the little feet look like. You know, so that was just some drops from the hole saw welded onto a little stub of pipe, and you know, they just come down here. And I forgot to buy cotter pins when I finished this, and so I just put some copper wire in there, and it's fine. All it has to do is just keep from falling off when it lifts up. I should probably put some rubber pads on the bottom of that glue. You know, I think it's the paint is probably cured up enough that I can contact cement some rubber onto the bottom of those. Some anti-vibration rubber. Okay, thanks. Use here, gas shielded MIG welding is one of the cleanest processes there is. There is very little smoke involved with it. But still, the temperatures are so extreme in welding that any surface contamination that's on the metal, grease, old paint, things like that, that even though you think you've cleaned areas back, there's still going to be stuff there. Those vaporize and will come right up into where you're working, and the last thing you want to do is breathe those things in. So 3M makes a simple welding respirator